Morning. Morning.
Morning, Doctor.
Everything all right?
Yes, same as you.
No surprises.
All the readings are stable.
ECG.
Morning, sir.
Morning, doctor.
Morning, sir.
Fine, fine. Blood temperature normal, respiration steady, pulse rate.
56, sir.
Yes. Trifle rapid for him, isn't it? Why is that?
Perhaps he senses what he's in for, sir.
You must be looking forward to tomorrow, Dr. Allen.
Very much.
Yes, indeed. Television people will be arriving after lunch. You will give them every assistance.
We'll do what we can. Dr. Maitland.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think his chances are?
I should ask Dr. Bergen that.
Towel, madam?
Thank you. No, you're not old enough for this. It's not just tomato juice.
I'm awfully sorry. I'm sure he must have kept you awake all night.
No, not at all. It's a long trip from Los Angeles, all the noise and strangeness. Why shouldn't he cry?
Well, it's very kind of you. Very understanding.
What's his name?
Christopher. I wonder, would you mind holding him just for a minute?
No, not at all.
Here we go. Good, go on, try. Yell. Good for the lungs. Attaboy.
Ah, Dr. Bergen. Welcome.
Dr. Maitland.
How do you do?
Nice to see you.
Excuse me, sir.
I hope all of this isn't on my account.
Well, we're having a small reception afterwards.
Afterwards?
Now I expect you'd like to see your room.
I'd like to see John Soames.
There he is.
Are you sure we should try to wake him? I mean, he looks happier than most conscious people.
Well, he doesn't know whether he's happy or not. He's like a hibernating animal. You're going to make him human.
No, I'm going to try to make him conscious. You'll have to make him human.
Well, we're prepared for that.
All right, everybody, quiet down. 1 minute. 1 minute.
Now, let's not be all night with the lights here. And Nelly.
Yes, Tom?
Nelly. Okay, now, up. That's it. That's a bit
better. If I forget to ask that, give me a word.
Fine.
And Dave, where are you going to be curing you from?
From over here, Tom.
Michael. Michael? Can they hear me in the van?
Camera 2 start on me, then the doctor, then Mr. Soames.
Yes, that's okay. That's all right with me.
Pull out as Dr. Maitland approaches you.
It's okay.
All right, now, settle down, everybody. Settle down.
Clock up.
Stand by. Good luck. Yeah. Right. First
Much
position, please.
Stand by, Dave. Ident.
Probe interview 4257. John Soames.
Five,
take one.
Dr. Maitland, you're director of the Midland Institute of Neurophysiological Research.
Mm-hmm.
How did Mr. Soames come to be at your institute?
He was born at a nearby hospital. When his condition was discovered, they called our senior consultant who had him moved here. That was, of course, before I took up my present post.
And what is his condition?
He's been in coma since birth.
Could you elaborate on that, please?
Well, it was a difficult delivery. And our patient sustained damage to the sleep center at the base of the brain. As a result of this, he's been unconscious since the day he was born.
But he is alive. All other organs are normal?
Yes, his vital functions are working well. But he remains, as it were, very deeply asleep.
Why, after 30 years, is Mr. Soames still alive? Why isn't he dead?
Well, he's fed intravenously. His heartbeat has been kept minimal by the cold temperature of this tank. He's given regular daily massage to prevent muscular atrophy. In a strange way, Mr. Soames is very fit.
Dr. Maitland, thank you.
Take one. Two, give me a two-shot.
Now, Dr. Bergen, how did you first become interested in the case of Mr. Soames?
Well, the topography of the brain is my area of expertise. And with the help of the recent advances in stereotaxic surgery, I hope to locate the sleep center accurately, stimulate the affected area, and wake him up.
I see. And if the operation is a success, what then?
With completion of surgery, Dr. Maitland will be in charge of the patient.
Dr. Bergen, thank you. Thank you.
Take two.
Dr. Maitland,
when he wakes up, won't his mind be that of a baby?
Yes, exactly. A baby.
Come in.
Hello.
Hi.
Dr. Maitland asked me to give you this.
What is it?
It's a training program he worked out for Mr. Soames.
Mm. Have you read it?
Oh, yes. We all had a copy.
What do you think of it?
Well, I'm a doctor. Not a psychologist.
I see, Doctor. Would you like a drink?
No, thanks. I'm still on duty. Good night.
Good night.
This is Thomas Fleming, reporting from the Midland Institute of Neurophysiological Research. Neurologists, psychiatrists, and surgeons from many countries have been invited to observe this operation.
unique in the history of medicine.
Welcome to the
house.
I am standing in the visitors' gallery, looking down into the main operating theater. In a few moments, our visitors, and you, the viewing audience, will witness an operation that may bring to life a man who, for all normal intents and purposes, has been dead for 30 years. Here he is, John Soames. And that's Dr. Michael Bergen himself, seeing that his patient is placed in precisely the position that he requires for the operation.
The patient is ready, sir.
Thank you, sir. Everything okay?
Yes, fine.
First incision.
What did I eat lunch for?
I warned you.
And the drilling is about to begin to form an entry to the brain beneath.
He used to be a medical student once.
Throw him out. When they found he had no heart.
The position of the probe must be accurate to within half a millimeter. With this tiny probe, Dr. Bergen will attempt to stimulate the dormant area of consciousness. If he is successful, life will begin for Mr. Soames.
All right, 6 volts, 1 minute.
6 volts, 1 minute.
Operation is over. Dr. Bergen looks pleased. And that is Dr. Joseph Allen removing the bracket, suturing and closing up the wound.
So far, so good.
Dr. Bergen, I haven't been able to congratulate you yet.
Thanks.
It was a great show.
Well, that's nice.
You've enabled Dr. Maitland to conduct a fascinating educational experiment. Will you be staying to watch any of it?
I hadn't intended to, Dr.
Chaffin. We'll be covering it for television. 6-hour-long documentaries on Soames' progress from coal tank to first-class citizen.
Thank you. Dr. Maitland doesn't mind.
He knows all about it. Let me see if you can find it.
Good, Mr. Soames.
You're ticking over nicely.
Any chance of a wee nip, Doctor?
Oh. Yes, of course. Come in. What's it to be? Vodka?
Yes, neat, please.
This is a great moment for the Institute, and we have you to thank for it.
Well, I hope it's a great moment for the patient.
What if he never wakes up?
No show.
To Mr. Soames.
To Mr. Soames.
Oh, by the way, did you get a copy of my training program?
Yes, I did, thank you.
What do you think of it?
Well, it's very interesting. As a matter of fact, it's beautifully detailed. There's only one thing that I feel. It seems to me that it's a bit inflexible.
I'd say controlled, not inflexible.
At 3 weeks, he will stand, at 4, walk, 5, count, 6, learn to eat with utensils.
You don't think he can do it?
Well, I'm sure he can do it, but what's the rush?
Well, Soames is 30 years old. He hasn't the time a child has to learn all the skills he's going to need. Of course, when he does learn a skill, he'll be rewarded.
And what if he doesn't?
We should keep on trying.
Well, I'm sure it's splendid. Anyway, good luck with it.
A good steak instead of that pap they keep serving him.
His stomach isn't digesting properly yet. Here we go. Turn over.
I'll do that. I think we can have that off now.
no need to gulp it. Slowly will do. Slowly. We'll have to control those sudden movements. Soames, you're going to try to walk today. Take your first steps. Help him out.
Come on, Naomi, this is important. Come on.
Now stand up.
Come and get it. Stop that, Soames. You'll get it when you stand up. Good. Good. Now stand up. Now walk, Soames, like this. Very good. We're on our way. Will you help him, Mr. Burns?
Come on, Soames. We don't want you to get it in
your eyes. For God's sake, stop it.
You can put him back now.
Like that, didn't you? There we go.
He can't have things all his own way.
Children have tantrums.
id and no superego. All drive and no control. When Soames wants something, he wants it immediately. And if he doesn't get it, he becomes angry. And it's a total anger capable of anything. That's why we have to teach him not only knowledge, but control. And quickly.
Yes, but you won't be teaching control. You'll be imposing it. And there is a difference.
Well, the end result will be the same. Acceptable behavior.
Acceptable to whom?
To the world at large. Bergen, as you know, some parents pick up their child the moment it cries. Other parents leave their child to cry, and after a while, the child learns the world will not adjust to him, he must adjust to it. Now, the second parents may seem heartless, but which is kinder in the long run?
I've got three kids. I always pick them up.
Well, naturally, it's up to each parent to choose.
Naturally.
Pour it in the bowl. more times. 3 and 5 makes 8. There are 8 pints in a gallon.
Wet water.
Yes, water is wet. Now pour another one in the bowl.
Why?
To learn.
Why?
Well, you don't want to be a baby forever, do you? Now pour another one in the bowl. Go on, Soames. So now he hasn't eaten anything for 2 whole days. He shows no interest in anything. Doesn't even respond to his name.
Well, that's blood pressure, reflexes, and respiration. All normal. According to these tests, he's conscious and alert.
I'm not disputing the tests. I'm looking at the man in front of us. And it appears very much as though he's sinking back into the comatose state he was in before the operation.
Now, Soames, listen to me.
is your name? I know you can hear me. Soames, stop sulking.
John? John? Oh, give me a hand. Do you want a drink of water? Hey, John. How about a bath? Hmm?
If a second operation should be necessary.
I hope not. Could I have a few minutes alone with him, please?
Yes, of course.
John, I have something for you. Brought it all the way from London. Would you like to see how it works?
Educational and enjoyable at the same time, you know.
How often has he been out?
Well, at the present moment,
Has he been out at all?
He's not ready.
How many people has he met?
I don't see what this has to do with his physical condition.
Has he had any more tantrums?
No, on the contrary. He's been fascinated, and he is developing. He's learned more in a few weeks than a normal child learns in years.
If you don't let up, you're going to teach Mr. Soames to death.
Now, listen to me, Soames. You won't gain anything by refusing to eat. You'll only disappoint us and make yourself ill.
You won't go to the lavatory either, Doctor.
Oh, now, that's ridiculous, Soames.
Hi.
Where are your friends?
Hi.
Would you like us to eat with you? Bring the soup over, will you, Nichols?
Oops. I hear you're staying for a while.
Yes, as long as I'm allowed.
Toys?
Mm-hmm. I bought out the store.
Well, now, suppose he wants to play all the time and refuses to work or study.
Well, he'll get tired of playing. After a while, he'll decide he wants to learn something. And he'll learn all the better once he's made the decision for himself.
Well, that's not exactly what Dr. Maitland believes.
Well, it's what I believe. What do you believe?
Now, open your mouth, Soames.
Oh.
We were having a little trouble with the feeding. Now, John.
Ow! Nichols, leave him alone. Nichols, leave him alone.
John, John, John. Ball. 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 Boom. John, catch. 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 Out. Good, John. Very good. Come on. Good, John. Very good. John, good. There we go. Very good, John. Good, good, good. Now, Dr. Maitland. Smile. Big smile. Good, John. Good. Good, John. Very good. Come on now, join in. John wants to play.
Very good. Good boy.
John.
Good. Good. Fine. Good. That's...
What was he resisting?
John.
Food. He didn't want to eat.
John.
All right, get some food.
Six plates. We're all going to eat with Mr. Soames. Right?
All right,
get it. Come on now.
Come on. Get it. Get it. Oh. Hello, boy. Oh. They keep smiling. All right, good. Ready. Here we go. Here we go.
Alice's crazy tea party.
Very good, John. Spoon. Spoon. John Soames Spoon.
Ah.
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 Trying to hold him down before. Why don't you include me in some of this recreation periods?
With what object?
Give him an outlet for some of that rebellious energy of his. Let him take it all out on me.
What precisely do you intend to do?
I think I'll let that be John's first decision.
You're one lap behind, John.
No.
Yes, you are.
That was fifth time.
Fifth.
Fourth.
Fifth.
Yeah. If you don't hurry up, you're going to be two laps behind.
I'm winning. Yeah. You're lying.
I won't play.
Well, I don't care.
I like it just as well without
you. No, no. Look, look, we start again. Right, John? I want red car.
Why?
It's best.
No, it isn't. It's just the brightest.
I want it.
Please. Damn it, John, your manners are terrible.
Damn it, I want it, please.
All right, give it to him. All right. Now, this time, you count down, John.
Five, four, three, two, one, go.
Oh, you cheated, John. You're not supposed to start until you say go, and you cheated. You cheated every game, the whole day, and I'm tired of...
There we are. Sleep well, John. Pleasant dreams.
Dreams? Yes. You know, all those nice places you go when you fall asleep. You close your eyes and go to sleep now and you'll dream about the house. Remember? On the farm. And you'll see the horse, the cow, the dog. All those lovely things outside.
John!
let him out?
I opened the door.
Why?
I'll get the right door and get into a panic.
What then?
Well, we'll show him.
Suppose he runs out the gate.
How are your legs?
Spindly.
It'll do you good then. You see?
John! John! Mr. Soames, where are you?
Damn!
Mr. Soames! John! Oh, we've been looking for you everywhere.
Inside. Don't hurt him.
Don't let him get behind the trees. Get hold of his arm.
Mr. Nichols! Gently, Mr. Nichols!
Hey. Have a nice cup of tea, John. Come on, and get some nice egg and bacon down here. It's a bit too cold.
Need a blanket.
Take him inside.
Jim, go and get cleaned up. I'll stay with him.
John.
John, listen.
No! No!
A stupid, irresponsible thing to do. I should have thought you'd had more sense.
Oh, for God's sake, Maitland. He was happy out here. He was exploring and learning about the world at first hand.
Dr. Bergen. The Institute is very grateful for
he
what you did.
He was going back of his own free
to
will.
To show our gratitude, I allowed you your play sessions with him, much as I disagreed. Now I'm afraid I can no longer allow you to influence our patient.
Patient? Soames is a person. He has done an experiment on which to test your ideas.
Or yours?
Would you like something to eat? John, I know you're clever, and I know you're going to understand. You'll be free to go out there when your training is over.
When?
Well, let's say 6 months.
How long is 6 months?
It's not long.
Soames, feeling better?
He hurt Soames before.
Jim didn't mean to hurt you. He was told to bring you in.
I'm hungry.
It's all that running about, huh?
We'll eat together. Jim, bring some fresh bread and cheese. And some cocoa.
Yeah, sure.
This is the latest.
All right, Sergeant. Put out an alarm.
Yes, sir.
Your man, Nichols, the nurse, how is he?
Well, he...
He has a concussion.
Is he going to die?
No. I don't think so.
Well, it shouldn't take long to catch him. He's never been outside before. He won't know what to do. We must remember that mentally he's... Well, he's only a small child.
Have you ever had to catch a runaway child, Doctor?
No.
I have. Several. The last one got to New York.
Can I give you a lift? I'm going as far as Tilfield. Up in. What are you dressed like that for? Training for the Olympics. I do a lot of business in Tilfield. I'm in plastic. Cups and saucers and that sort of thing. I fill a lot of the factory canteens. Bright colours, you know. Friendly. Makes a meal of pleasure. Some designs also. Floral mostly. They seem to like those. I don't know whether it's the flowers they go for.
You drink, or maybe you prefer to get it yourself.
Drink, yes, please.
Kind of draught.
Milk, please.
I was wondering what you were on about. Kidder. Here, that's not funny.
What's going on around here?
Wish I knew. Spitting out our good draught all over the floor.
We'll want an explanation for that, or you'll be required to vacate these premises.
And he hasn't paid for the sandwiches either.
That'll be 4 and 11 pence, including the beverage. I think you've had a drop too much, if you'll pardon me. Come along, sir.
Thank you.
think you're doing? Watch it. Get on with the game.
Nichols has come to. He'll be all right. There's no permanent damage.
Thank heaven for that.
Any more news?
No.
What's going to happen to Soames when they find him?
Well, if we're lucky, they'll let him come back here.
And if we're not lucky?
It depends on what he does between now and then.
Are you all right? Can you move? Try. Don't worry. We'll take care of you. Richard! Let's get him into the car.
What are we going to do with him?
Help me lift him. He must be in shock. Be careful.
I'm being careful. Now what do?
We take him to the hospital.
Oh, fine. First thing they'll do is phone the police. I'll get 6 months this time. Is that what you want, Jenny?
No, Richard. That's not what I want.
Be sure. Give you a little time for yourself. Are you sure that's not what you want?
Oh, shut up and take us home.
Home?
It'll give us time to think. And time for you to sober up.
You drive.
It's all right. I'm just going to clean you up a bit. How do you feel? Do you remember what happened?
Happened?
Last night.
Lights.
A car? You see, we found you. lying by the roadside near here. It must have been a hit-and-run driver. Are you hungry?
Hungry, yes.
Then we'll feed you. Would you like to get up?
Where are my clothes?
I've washed them. I'll bring you breakfast in bed, and then I'll iron everything. Perhaps you'd like a bath. Right in here. Mr. Soames?
Yes.
John Soames.
John Soames.
You're wanted for attempted murder, Mr. Soames. You tried to kill a man. You hurt him very badly.
Nichols hurt me.
Locked you up? Now listen. I think you ought to stay here for a day or two. Until you're really well and able to go. Do you understand what I'm saying? Poor Mr. Soames. I don't know what they did to you. But I'm sure you never wanted to hurt anybody. And I'm not going to tell the police. Because it was my useless, drunken husband who knocked you down. He's a lot more dangerous than you are. And I can't remember the time. He was half as gentle as you're being now.
Moore speaking. Go ahead.
Phone call from Mr. Richard Bannerman, 22 Folland Drive.
You tell them what?
I just said we found him injured in the road. It puts us in the clear, you see. Now keep him there. The police are on their way.
We have to hurry. The police are coming.
Hurry? Where?
To the Institute. We have to get you back to your doctors before the police arrive.
No. No more Institute.
My husband has the car. I'll take you by train. The station's at the bottom of the road. But I know you don't understand. Poor John. Please, trust me. I'll get my coat. You stay here. John?
John Soames.
Where to, please?
A ticket, please. Thank you.
London?
London.
She's coming in now. Change of Bedford. Hold on. We'll have 15 and a penny for that.
Mama.
Next stop's 15 miles down the line, sir.
Soames was definitely on it.
Yes, sir.
Was anyone with him in the same compartment?
They didn't know that, sir.
Let them know he's coming.
London is the capital of England. I am going to London. My name is John Soames. What is your name?
Melanie. Melanie Parks.
Melanie.
Right.
Did he attack you?
He tried to. He reached for me. Oh, please, hurry.
Come on, Ted.
Somewhere around Tilfield. They're out searching for him now. Get onto the office and tell them to send down the camera crew and the van. Come on, step to it.
Inspector Moore just called. They found Soames.
Thank God. Where is he? Is he hurt?
They don't know. He's in a bar on the other side of Tilfield. The police are surrounding it now.
How far is that?
Oh, about 20 minutes at the outside.
Spoken to him yet?
I was waiting for you, Doctor.
Where is he?
In there.
All right, Steve. You'll be up on the roof with the camera. You get up with him with the spotlights.
Okay.
When I bang on the headlights, you hit the spots.
Right.
Soames, can you hear me? You must be very tired. Please come out now, and we'll give you something to eat and put you to bed. Soames, I asked you if you could hear me. You don't want to stay there all night, do you? Soames? John Soames?
Be careful. He may have some kind of weapon.
I think I know how to handle Soames. You don't want me to get angry, do you, Soames?
Don't do it, Dr. Maitland. Don't go in there.
Soames, I'm telling you for the last time. Are you coming out, or do I have to come in and fetch you?
No, no! Go away!
Oh, for God's sake, don't frighten him. He may panic and do something else violent.
Your advice, Dr. Bergen, on each and every occasion has been signally disastrous.
Right, we'll discuss that later. Our job now is to get him to come out of his own free will, act sane and responsible. Yeah, we're not going to achieve that by shouting at him.
Gentlemen, we don't want to be here all night.
May I try?
Certainly.
Dr. Bergen, it might be dangerous.
I'm willing to take that risk.
John? It's Dr. Bergen. I want to talk to you.
John. John?
They are outside. I heard.
They don't mean any harm.
They will take me back.
Don't you think it's best, John?
I don't know.
What happened to you, John? Are you hurt?
My leg.
How did you do that?
I fell after the train.
Could I see it? Please. In the car, and drink, and food.
Food?
Can you walk?
Yes, walk.
Do you think he can make him come out?
He won't try to make him do anything.
I'm not going to force you, John. It's up to you. I'm going to the car, and you can come if you like.
I don't know.
You must decide for yourself.
Don't go.
All right. He's coming out of his own accord.
Not yet.
Over here. Get in the car.
Dr. Bergen!
It's up to you, John. It's your decision.
Turn those off, damn it!